Create new. Put any name you want. For example, wood clamp. Select part design. Select create sketch. Choose XY plane. Choose create rectangles. To position the center of the rectangle in the center of the XY plane, select the 3 points in the order shown on the screen and press constrain symmetrical. To change the size of the rectangle, select one of the horizontal and vertical sides and press constrain distance. Press close and next pad. At length, we enter the height we want on the Z-axis. Now I created a body. To change the height of the body on the Z-axis, we select body, placement, position, and on Z we enter the desired positive or negative height. Continue to make the second sketch, select body and press space to make it invisible. Then we press sketch and select the XY plan. We make a rectangle and place in the center of the XY plan. Enter the desired dimensions for the new rectangle. We select body and press the spacebar to make it visible again. We see that the new rectangle is at the base of the body. So we have to take it to the upper part of the body. For this, we change the position on the Z-axis. With sketch 001 selected, we go to pocket. For the length, we select the depth of the pocket. To make another pocket, we repeat the previous procedure from sketch 001. To make a hole in the center of the body, we make another sketch. This time we make a circle. We put the circle in the center of the XYZ axis and select the desired diameter. Select body and press the spacebar to make the body visible again. We select sketch 003 and we see that the circle is at the base of the body, so we will change its height on the Z-axis. We select the hole and check the diameter of the hole. At this moment, I have finished the drawing of the piece. Now we go to the path to create a job. At output, we select the type of software we use. At tools, we select the type of tool used and functioning parameters. In this case, I am using an end mill with a diameter of 4 mm. Delete the default tool and set the new end mill as number 1. We also set the horizontal and vertical advance and spindle speed. This is how I created a job. Now to create the path, we can choose one of the following operations. For the hole, I choose the profile operation. We go to base geometry and select the circle from the base of the drawing. Now we can see that a path has been generated. At depths, we see the depth at which the path starts and ends. At step down, we select the depth of each layer. In the case of the front, we will use 1 mm. At heights, we see the height at which the end mill can safely pass without hitting the part or other bodies. During the operation, we see that the path is mat outside the hole, which is not good for the present case. We go to CAM simulator and do a simulation. We go again to operation and select inside. We see that this time the path was mat inside the hole. We see that this time the milling is done inside the hole as we want. So I finished the first milling operation. Now let's do the second operation. We will make a slot on the left side of the piece. For step down, we will use 1 mm. We will extend the path by 1 mm on both parts. We do a simulation and we see that everything is okay. We make a slot on the right side as well. And this time everything seems okay. The fourth and last operation will be an outer profile. We select all four sides of the piece. So that the piece remains fixed on the table, we will use the tag dress up function. To generate the G-code, we will use the POST process, where we write the name of the file, and at the end we will attach the ending NC. We load the G code into Mach 3 and start the milling operations.